Hey everybody, it's Nick here with a new tutorial, and I wanted to dive into this new functionality in After Effects 2017, which allows you to do 3D extrusions on text and shapes and stuff right in After Effects. It uses the Cinema 4D render engine, but you don't have to, you know, even go into Cinema 4D at all. You can just do it all in After Effects. All right, so I got the text set up. And just to go over it, I just have these three text layers and the anchor point's right in the center. Everything is centered up to the center of the comp, and I want to spin these around. And right now my render is on classic 3D, and I'm just going to do a very basic 3D text spin, the 2.5D flat text spin. And what I like to do is actually link these to a null, a 3D null. And before I make it 3D, I'm going to center the anchor point and center it right at the very center of the comp. And then I'm going to turn it 3D. And the reason I did that is because it will not align a 3D layer for some reason. So you have to align it all up before you make it 3D. And I'm going to link all these to the null. And the reason I do this is so that when I spin the null, the 3D text will spin as well. But it makes everything feel like a much more cohesive, animation where I can just modify the keyframes of one layer, and that feels like one just kind of complete motion. And you'll see what I mean when I do it. So I'm going to go and rotate the Y. And I'm going to do 180. And obviously my text is backwards now. I'm not going to worry about it because I'll just flip that over. But I want everything to feel very kind of cohesive when I add easing and stuff like that. And that doesn't feel cohesive at all, but here we go. It's gonna cut right in the center there. Yeah. And then do another rotation here. And maybe spin back to zero. All right, so that's okay for now. I got a little bit of easing on these. And what I want to do first is go and fix the scale so this flips back over. So I'm going to unlink this scale property and do negative 100. It just makes it easier because if you have to end up modifying these keyframes, you're not working in multiple layers to make the spin seem like it's, you know, natural. And we'll get into that a little bit later. So one thing I like to do with this type of effect is add a camera. And the camera doesn't really even need to move. But I like to actually do this short focal length. It might be on like 50 or something, so modify this to 15. And this gives it a little bit more perspective. It gives it that kind of fisheye thingy. And just makes it just sells the 3D a little bit more. And I might actually just move it back some, so it's not so in your face. All right, so let's get into extruding these layers. The first thing you need to do is go into your renderer and change this to Cinema 4D. Now you need 2017 to do this, Otherwise, you'll just have the ray trace 3D. I've never gotten into the ray trace 3D. It's always ran just super slow, and it's just been kind of annoying, and I just never really used it. So the thing about the Cinema 4D is it's basically using the Cinema 4D Lite that comes with every After Effects thing, and it kind of works like Cineware, so you can't add mask or anything like that to it, to the layer once you have this renderer on. They just won't work, and then certain effects won't work, but all the text animation stuff will work, so you can use the presets and things like that. And this, and when you go into the options, this is kind of what you're going to be seeing in terms of quality, and you want it in this draft mode because it's going to just, you're going to be able to work a lot faster, and then when you go to render, you'll want to, you know, put up, I think midway would, you know, would be fine, but if you were really picky about some of the edges and anti-aliasing, you might want to go way up, but it's going to really take some time to render. So I'll have quality at 20. Right off the bat, nothing's happened. But if you twirl down some of these effects settings, you go into the, you get some geometry options. And this is where you can start extruding things. And just to make this very apparent, I'll do 50. And you can already start to see what's happening here. But it doesn't look very good because there's no lighting. It's almost like putting a luminance channel material on it. So it's just very flat. And so let's do that. Let's put some lights on. So what I'm going to do is go to a 2 view kind of thing. So I can see the top view over here. And just get some lights going. New light. Do white light. Point light. Hit okay. And now my light is right here. It's this facing this layer straight on. And I'm going to duplicate that. And move one to the left. Sorry, one, two. It's kind of like a fill light. Might move my key like over here some, and then duplicate again and move it. Actually move it behind. And over top. So you can see over here, you know, where it's going on the y-axis. And you can see right here that it's behind. And, you know, that's looking okay for now. I can start to see some of the shading and some of the edges. And let's move our camera up just so I can see this better. Move this, this light ahead. So I just have a basic three-point lighting kind of thing going on here. And what I want to do as well is put some edges on this thing so I can get some cool kind of bevels and things like that. And there's a few different options here. You have the angular. Let me pull up the and I'll just make this really extreme so you can see, which is just kind of like a 45 degree edge on it. And I think if you have this as at like a 2, it's very subtle and nice. It bounces the light right off. You also have this concave for a more decorative kind of look. That could work really nice as well. And then the convex gives it that kind of fat look. That's not too bad as well. But I think I'm just going to stick with angular at a 2. And this is just going to give me these edges on the you know, the corner of the S, and that like little glint on the C. And if I didn't have that, you wouldn't see that as much. It just a little nice little detail. So now I have this extruded. And I'll turn this back to quarter because it's giving me a hard time. I'll go back to one view as well. So the cool thing about this is that now that I, you know, say this is the look that I want to go for, and I think I might actually make this a little skinnier now, just to give it just the sledge 3D look, I will take these geometry options and copy them with Command C and go to my 3D text layer and Command V, and it copies all of those, and same thing here. So I don't have to worry, you know, that I have to go and manually put those all in. I can just copy and paste them, which is super convenient. I can also change the color, and it just updates right away, which is nice. And then you can go into your text animators and, you know, mess with them as well, and do that whole thing. But we'll just stick to this spinning animation right now. So one thing I want to do is, and this is where the null object comes in handy, is to open it up, and I like to kind of undershoot the spin, so it doesn't spin right to 180 and then, you know, it just stays there. I want it to kind of rotate while it's, you know, on that layer. So I'll undershoot this by going to 165. And then I'll overshoot it over here by 15,195. That way it will have that kind of... And I'll do the same thing here where it'll undershoot it, go to 15. And then as it's making its way around, it will go to negative 15. And it just gives it a little nice motion while it's, you know, showing you this text. And next thing I want to work on is kind of lining these up so they flip right at that. Yeah. So it's nice, now that I'm adding this little like detail with easing and stuff, all I have to do is mess with these two keyframes instead of messing with like four keyframes on these different layers. And it will take some finesse to get this right, to sell that flip as being, you know, but it just makes it a whole lot easier. And now that I have these lights and stuff going, I have 3D text. I didn't enter Cinema 4D at all, and it's looking pretty good. So that's it for me. There's, you know, tons of places you can take this, but this is the basic principle of this, and shout out to Adobe for doing this, finally. it's just been a long time coming. All right, so I hope this helps you, and if you haven't already, get... Creative Cloud 2017, well worth it. And I'll see you next time.